Tabata cardio workout. We're going to warm up just side to side as I go through and tell you what we're doing. We're going to take 8 different intervals for the Tabata to step it out while we're starting. We'll go right into the first one. I'll modify throughout the entire workout. Julia will be doing some modifications as well. She's good now. Again, if there's going to be a 1-minute cardio after every one of the Tabata sets. If you don't feel comfortable doing any of them, you can do a march in place. Bring those arms up. We just want to keep the heart rate elevated the whole time during that 1 minute. The Tabata is going to be 20 seconds long. We'll have a 10-second break. I like active rest. If you don't want the active rest, you can completely rest, but it's going to be a 10-second active rest there. So we're going to go ahead and get started. We'll start off slow with the squats, and then we'll continue to increase the intensity as we get started, as we warm up. So, a little bit too loud, let me know if it's too loud.
Yeah, I can let you know.
It's okay, and you can mess around with it too. So, the first Tabata is going to be a squat. So we're just going to stay grounded on the first one. We're just going to drop it down, push the weight into your heels again. There's going to be 8 of these. They'll each last 20 seconds. You can take a complete break for the 10 seconds. We're going to do lunge backs, 4 to 6. Push your weight into your heels. And we're going to lunge back. You knock back so you can stay still. You want? 4 to 6. We're going right back into the squat again. Take those legs out wide. Go right into that squat again. Again, you're dropping those heels. We're dropping down into your heels. The weight is going back. Breathing it out. Turn it to the side. Try to go as deep as you feel comfortable going. Imagine someone's got their hands on the outside of your knees, and you're pressing just gently against their hand. Again, you can take a break. We can add a lunge back here. And I'll do 4 to 6. I'll take a quick break. We're going to take it a little bit higher. We're coming up off those heels. Again, you can keep grounded the entire 8 spot around. If you want, breathing it out. Those arms into it, just warming up that body a little bit more each time again. Break if you need it. If not, 4 to 6 lunges. Set yourself up and go. Again, heels are elevated. If you're breathless, after those 20 seconds, then take that break. If you still got a little bit left, then try to push with those active breaths. Breathing it out. Take those heels up.
2, 1.
And again,
rest.
Let if you feel comfortable with them. We're going to add a little bit of a hop. You don't have to if you don't want to.
Prepare and work.
So, floating up off that ground, 20 seconds. Push those arms back. Breathing it out. And as you start these, you may need those 10-second breathers. That's fine.
If
you can lunge back, if you want to step here, that's fine, whatever feels comfortable for you. Set yourself up. 3 more. Here we go. Explode. Put those hands in front, push those arms back as you explode up to the ceiling. Almost there.
1.
Lunge back.
Cycle 6. 8.
Julie wasn't prepared for a whole hour. She thought we were just showing exercises. So, follow her. Here we go. 2 more. Down and up. Down and up. We're almost there. Tighten it down. Hold it down. Sorry. Keep it going. Breathing it out for me. So you get to that squat.
3, 2.
Lunge back, your heart rate should be elevated. A little breathless, that's good. 1 more. We've got this.
Prepare.
Here we go. Down, explode it up. Pause at the bottom. Sink into that nice strong squat. Yeah, if you have to do a squat without the hop, that's fine. So last round. Listen to your body.
two, one.
Do 1 minute brace.
Tabata.
You can march here.
Cover.
You can fake jump rope, or we're going to jump rope for a minute. If you don't have a jump rope, this is the only time you're going to use it. Fake it if you want. 1 minute. The next one's going to be abs. So we're going to go down to the floor. We're doing what I call a butterfly ab. For the 20 second intervals. Again, if you don't have a jump rope, you're here. Here. You don't need equipment to get this out, workout in. We're going to be using all the major muscle groups here. This minute to get the heart rate elevated. If it isn't already elevated. And release. We're dropping down to floor one. It's the butterfly ab. Sideways, you can see Julia. Heels are in the ground.
Four, three.
We're going to come up.
One.
Control shoulder blades as you lift yourself up. Modification is just the crunch where you're not coming all the way up. You're lifting the upper back off the floor. Put your feet with your body fairly close to the floor.
One.
Brace.
Cycle.
It's a reverse curl. Again, 4 to 6. Or a complete break if you need it.
Prepare and work.
And butterfly up. You bring those hands over your head. Kind of gives you a little assistance. And coming up. Again, pinch those shoulder blades. Elbows. Right there, and reverse curls.
Rest. Cycle.
Your elbows are going to be shoulder height when you come up out of those. Drop your feet down. And third round.
The wedding.
Rest. Yes, I do. I just have three. Thank you.
Complete.
Mine's in the car. And again, reverse curls, 4 to 6.
Prepare
and bring up that butterfly. Thank you, Mine. If you need to take a break, just give yourself those 10 seconds.
To
stay on the floor.
Rest.
You can bridge up.
Complete.
If you start to feel anything in the lower back, remember we're engaging through that entire core. So if you need to stretch it, that 10 seconds is perfect. Scoop those abs up. Breathe it in out.
Two, one, rest. Cycle 5, complete.
And drop me down.
Prepare.
Get back into that butterfly. Breathe it out for me here. Pull it up. Just the bottom round is almost over.
Two, one, rest.
And reverse curls.
Complete.
4 to 6. Back down.
There and work.
Take those butterflies up. Pinch your shoulder blades in the back.
Two, one, rest. Cycle 7.
One more. Reverse curls. 4 to 6. We have one more butterfly you won't see in the rest of the day. One more round.
Prepare.
Here we go. So the next 1 minute is a mountain climber. You can do those mountain climbers on the floor really slow. You can stand up and do that marching with the arms pressing up. Just give me 1 minute
of a constant
to cardio rest.
So again,
six, complete.
1 minute, flip over, mountain climber, you can go slow or you can take it fast. 1 minute, you work your pace.
Prepare and
on the floor. Here we go. Last set of push-ups. on the floor, step pump, step plank. She's showing the harder version of it, and then I'm going to show you. You can step side to side. I step up out of the hand. So, what she's showing you is a step stomp, it's a plank. We're going to step up by our hands. Plant that foot on the floor. Again, if you don't like that one, what I'm showing you, the side squat. Which one are you doing, darling? Do the side squat, standing up. I'll show the step stomp. This is our 1 minute. Yep, yep. Julie's doing the alternative. 1 minute. Just the move itself should be challenging on this one. So your heart rate should be elevated. Oh, it's gonna be. Breathe a little harder. That's it. The next move is ski lunge. We can all do these. The level of intensity will come from the speed and the hop, the height. So ski lunge first, the top of the lunge. This, Julia, sweep to the side. She's recovering from an ACL replacement, so she's not been released by her doctor yet. She has to be a little bit worse. So here, a hop. You can modify it. She feels comfortable, she can add that hop a little bit. Half squats if you need it. You can just a little bit of press. You don't have to. If you want to take a break, take a break. Stand up. Round two. Here we go.
Work.
Do you have to touch the floor? Absolutely not. The hand on that thigh. You can add the hop. Still go slow. Again, a lot of variation. Listen to your body.
2, 1.
Half squats is an option.
Cycle 2, complete. Prepare and
stand. Third round. At this point in the workout, hopefully, you're starting to feel a little winded, and you may need those 10 seconds in between each Tabata. You may be like, oh, you break the timer under water now.
Complete.
Whatever you need. Here we go. Drop it down.
Prepare and work.
Breathe in and out for me. You can add the hop. You can really float out of those. Half squats as an option only.
Cycle 4, complete.
We're not going down deep. Perfectly fine.
Prepare.
Stand it up. Go. Half squat option, you don't have to, stand still.
Cycle 5.
Keep those legs walking. 4 to 6 of these. Stand up. Ho, 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 ho.
Prepare.
Go back again.
Work. Cycle 6, complete.
2 more of these, we got 2 more. That will be it.
Prepare.
Here we go.
Work.
Number 7. Modify as you need to. The intensity's not there yet. Bump it up a little bit. You're getting tired on this one.
One.
Slow down.
Cycle 7.
One more. Then we get to 1 minute, and oh, my favorite.
Prepare and
here we go. Keep on going. It's your last one. Last year.
Two.
Alright, so 1 minute.
Rest.
Squat hop. In and out.
Recover for
here, squat. You can pause on the out, but you can tap squat. Tap squat. Or you can hop and hold in each position. It's totally up to you. 1 minute though. Heart rate's gonna get elevated. If you can't do this, remember, this is when you're doing all these. In between, or jog, in between, just keeping the heart rate elevated. It's a longer 1 minute round. So here's your cardio aspect, Tabata cardio. Heart rate's elevated. Tabata, this is really concentrated cardio. We're going back down the floor again. Doing abs. Chill wipers. I'll turn and face you. I'll keep doing you sideways. You can see it. A lot of you guys have become TikToks. Windshield wipers. Woo! Alright, windshield wipers. Bring the mat back in. Again, I'm
going to ready for Tabata 2.
Long ways. I'll go right here. You can see Julia. Elbows are grounded into the floor. So plant those elbows down into the floor. Drive your elbows to the floor. Legs go side to side. As far as you can feel comfortable. Push into your elbow. Push into your elbow. If you want to put a flat palm down, that's fine also. If you drive your elbows, you get a little bit more control to those obliques. Your brain's good here. It's going to be a one-leg bridge, 3 to 4 on each leg, 3 to 4 each leg, then bring the both up,
and
again, windshield. Round two. One-legged bridges.
Two, complete.
You'll switch legs. As an opt-out, you don't have to do these.
Prepare
and then windshield. Elbow on the floor. You want to hold weight? You can hold weight down there. Breathe in and out for me. Breathe in and out.
Three, two,
yeah, you do not have to add these right here. You don't have to add those if you don't want them. Breathe in and out.
Prepare
and take it to complete break if you want to. Work with the obliques. Side abdominals, you probably won't feel it down the center too much.
One. Rest.
Glute.
Cycle four.
Hamstring on the leg that's on the ground. So I'm engaging the glute and the hammy on my grounded leg for this part. And go. Side to side. Drive those elbows into the ground. Good. Good, good, good. Yes, if you want to palm down, that's fine also. Breathe in and out for me.
Three, two, one.
3 to 4 on each leg.
5, complete.
You don't want them, but you want to break. Again, perfectly fine. Here we go. Another round.
Work. Six.
We have 2 more rounds, folks. 2 more rounds. We can do this one. We'll stand up after these 2 rounds.
And
here we go. Make sure you're breathing. Don't hold your breath on me. Breathe it out.
Three, two, one.
Here we go. Three, four.
Seven, complete.
Woohoo! We're almost halfway through the workout. What?
Prepare and work.
And go. Breathe it out. Drop all doubles to the floor.
Three, two, one. Rest. Tabata two.
Stand up slowly. Switches in front of the floor. We're doing alternating lunge back to straight back. Again, hands go onto the knees. You can come down and touch the floor with the fingertips. You do what feels comfortable. This next exercise is in the upper body. It's a little more challenging. I'm going to have Julia do a marching plank hop on the plank. The feet go straight up. Remember, the heels come up to the ceiling. I'll show you that. This is a push plank. It's like doing this handstand. Don't really care to do handstand, so I like this alternative for the handstand. This one is challenging. Follow Julia on the alternative move for this one. 1 minute of these alternating lunge backs. You can add the hop. Breathe in and out for me. Go. There. So, Julia's dropping down. Her marching plank consists of this. Elbows are forearms. She's going to hold a strong plank. She's going to march. I'm going to come into a hover. Palms are on the floor. Toes are facing away from me. Butt up in the air. I'm going to bring the crown of my head down towards the floor. Like I'm doing a beginning six with a handstand, but I never really truly get there. Julia's doing it from a hand position. You can also do it from a forearm position, which I'll show you the next round. Tuck the head down.
One.
Take a break. Those should be challenging, so I'm not going to give you an alternative move. In the middle, that should be in the middle. You can hold a plank. Here's the same marching plank as Julia was doing.
And
you're lifting. You can do it from the knee. And lift that knee up off the ground. There are tons of modifications on there. So don't feel like you can't get one of these to work for you. Probably one of these are going to be doable.
Three, two,
take that break. I'm going back to the push press.
Cycle two.
Pick whichever one you want. You okay? You can push press, whatever you want. Here we go. 30 seconds.
And work.
Tuck it in tight. Breathe it out for me. You're touching the crown of your head and not your forehead.
Three, two,
tuck that chin in if you're doing those.
Cycle three.
Go back to the child's pose if you want. Stretch it out. That's your third set. Woo!
Prepare.
Here we go.
Work.
Your goal is to challenge yourself with whichever move you pick. Make sure you're challenging
two,
yourself.
One.
Child pose.
Cycle four complete.
Sweaty. Here we go. Four more. You're halfway there.
Prepare and
no. Julia's asked for doing the entire routine again, so we're not going to overdo it.
Two, one.
Take a break.
Rest. Cycle five, complete.
All right, three more. Again, you can do a child pose if you want. Stretching it out. If you want to stretch it out, that's fine. Get three more. Here we go. Remember, the crown of your head is going down there. This one is a challenging move. Modify as needed.
Two, one, rest.
Two more.
Cycle six, complete.
And go!
This is a lot of shoulder overload. You're doing the push press.
3, 2, 1.
Woohoo!
Cycle.
One more. That's it, ladies. We'll stand up. We'll do a leg squat hop. 1 minute. Just like the first one we did in the warm up, you squat. You don't have to add that hop. This is our last one here. Crown goes down, not the forehead. Squat up. 1 minute. Do you have to add that hop? Absolutely not. If you can't touch the floor, hands on the thighs, just fine. You're in your house by yourself. Nobody's gonna call you out. You gotta listen to your body. Next move is abs. We're gonna bring the mats back in. Up there. 1 minute. 1 minute. Woo. Back to the floor, the starfish abs. Legs are as wide as your mat. Wider than your shoulders.
Get ready for Tabata.
Come on down, sister. Hands are wide. Out the wide. Touch your left hand. Your right toe into V up.
5, 4, 3, 2,
and go. Touch, come down, switch, come down, switch, come down, switch. Breathe it out. So now we're having a moving bridge. Just a little bit of breather. Tighten up to the lower back. Back here, feels good. Legs out, arms out. And go. Modification. Just back to here. We're not pulling on the head. Little baby crunches. Just take those crunches side to side. If need be, bridge it up. 4 to 6, depending on how long you hold at the top. Back to the starfish, third round.
Prepare.
Here we go.
Work.
Prepare
and work.
There you go.
Raise them up.
Rest.
Two more.
Complete.
And our absolute favorite cardio for the last minute. We'll do a little modification for the rest of the class.
And
hey, go. We're stuck. One more starfish. Then we're going to stand up slowly. Set those legs out.
And
let go. Okay, I stand up slowly.
Rest.
Last minute.
Tabata, eight, complete.
Burpees.
For 1 minute.
Burpees, go. Since I'm over 50, I don't have to do them. Go. Burpee, burpee, burpee. I will do them, but I'm going to show you the modification. If you just want to step out to the side, take this one. If not, burpees. You don't have to add the push-up if you don't want to. If you want to, that's fine. Pace yourself. 1 minute is a long time. Prepare and go. 20 seconds is all you're doing. 20 seconds. the reverse ab curl. Either one, I'm doing butterfly for you.
Prepare.
Here we go. You start early. I'm sorry. It's alright. This is our second, only two. It's all we're doing. Second round of these.
Three, two.
Flip that baby.
Rest.
Mount climber.
Complete.
20 seconds only, then we're going into push-ups, so stay in this position or a plank.
Prepare.
Here we go.
Three,
stop it.
One.
So again,
rest.
Push-ups. 20 seconds.
Recover.
Or
2 minutes.
We don't get 2 minutes.
Get
or plank.
One.
For 20 seconds. Two rounds. In between that and that step stop, you can do, I'm going to show you a jack plank as the alternative for that. So push-ups or plank hold day you want. Plank. You want either way you want. 20 seconds. Julie's doing a plank for me. Either one of these are absolutely fine.
Two,
I'm going to show you the alternative that steps on when I'm going to put in your face.
One,
but we're going to go out to the side. That is going to be your alternative. That's your 20 seconds. Or I'm going to show you the steps on. You don't want them then. Here we go. Julia's doing the step stop. See Julia? Will she step in here? If you don't like that one, tap it out to the side. This is just 20 seconds, folks. We're not doing it for a minute this time. 20 seconds.
Two,
take a break.
One.
Back to the push-up or the plank. She's doing a plank or doing the push-up. Go for your knees, hands, or toes, whatever feels comfortable.
For
20 seconds, last one. You'll come. You'll see these today with me.
Two.
Woo! Again, step stomp.
Cycle three.
Julie was doing those before. Stomp up by your hand or by your elbow. Or jack out that plank.
Prepare.
I'll show you the jack out. Jack out is here. Julia's doing a step stomp. Keep going. Stand it up for me.
Rest.
Move your mat out of the way.
Complete.
If you need it. Gear lunge. Two rounds of those. In and out. Squat hops. We're going to be the second part of that. So, it's this move. Your heart rate should stay elevated. So, we're needing those 10 seconds at this point. So, hopefully, this is a true Tabata where you're breathless. In those 10 seconds, you're like, whoo, just to set yourself up for them.
Two,
take that break.
Rest.
In and out squat hops. Again, I showed you, you can do them here. Tap, tap, or you can pause out and pause in. I'm going to do pauses on both. Here we go. One, two. Bring it out for me.
Two,
all right,
one.
Go back to your lunge again.
Complete.
Woo!
Prepare.
Here we go. The next Tabata round that we're doing, I'm going to play with it just a little bit because I don't want you up and down. We're going to go to the floor and do an ab. So I'm going to give you an alternative.
Two.
Second move. Here we go.
Rest.
In and out.
Complete.
Keep ready. Get out here. Here we go. In and out. Swap up.
Prepare.
Grab your mat on your face. Here we go. Again, here. In and out. Nice alternative. Your other alternative, remember, modify to your level.
Three, two.
Down the floor, windshield wipers, TikToks, whatever you want to call those. Come on down.
For 1 minute.
We're not recovering at all at this point.
Get ready for tomorrow.
TikToks. Windshield wipers, whatever you want to call them. Then we're going to turn to a side plank on each side.
Five.
Legs up.
Four.
TikTok. Windshield wipe.
One.
Side to side. I'm going to have Julia do a side plank up on her toes. I'm going to do it on my knees just to show you. We will be faced away from you. She doesn't practice, she can face me. I'm going to face away just to show you the form.
Three. Two.
So I'm going to roll over to the side. I'm coming here, we're down my knees, shoulder elbow. This is the part that's really important. Shoulder elbow alignment, hand up, you're just gonna reach through. So I'm reaching through with my knee on the ground. She's gonna reach through with her foot elevated. Go ahead, baby. We're gonna go to the other side as well. So again, you can drop that knee down if you need to. Look to the other side. Look to the other side, and then we'll windshield wipe again. It'll all work out. Here we go. Again, up or down. Shoulder elbow alignment. That's crucial for you. Keep that shoulder stable. Lift that rib cage up. Breathing it out for me. We're going to go right back to the windshield wipers as soon as we finish this. Roll on your back.
Rest. Cycle three, complete.
Elbows digging into the ground, really drive your elbows down. It's almost like you're lifting your shoulder blades off the ground because you're pressing so hard into the ground with the elbow. Gonna force you to tighten up that core.
Three, two, one.
Turn to the side planks again for me.
Complete.
Turn to the side planks again. Shoulder elbows aligned. Crucial. Rib cage is up. Here we go. If you don't want to use that arm to move underneath it, you don't have to. Listen to that body of yours. Roll that baby over.
Rest. Cycle five. Complete.
Shoulder elbows.
Prepare.
Here we go.
Work.
Reach it through. We're going to those push planks. Julia's going to do a regular plank or a marching plank when she brought her heels up off the ground. Those are the left next two.
Two.
So,
rest. Cycle six, complete.
Julia's doing this one here. Just going to show you. This is your next one. Or butt up in the air.
Prepare.
Round to the head. Right here. We're going to stand up and do jump squats.
Two, one, rest.
Jump squats.
Seven, complete.
Woo-wee! Almost there, baby girl.
Prepare, and
here we go. Breathing it out for me. Come on, we're almost there. One more round of that push plank. One more, 20 more seconds. Woo, so too fast.
Ready for Tabata.
20 more seconds of the marching plank. Really fit into the marching plank. It's the last one for the day. You ready to take a look at it?
Five.
All right, come on, we can do this.
Two, one.
Here we go, 20 seconds. Slowly, come back up.
Two, one.
Ugh.
Rest.
Jump squat.
Complete.
Last round. Woo-hoo-hoo. Starfish or next.
And
here we go. Down and upwards.
Two,
beautiful.
One.
Get on the floor, starfish. We're going to finish off on the ground.
Complete.
Come on down, come on down. Starfish.
Prepare and work.
Up the arm, off the leg. One leg bridge,
three,
then the other leg bridge. 20 seconds on one leg, 20 seconds on the other. Tell. Foot to the ground, toes elevated if you can, if you don't have to. But I'm digging into that heel. We're just going to engage glutes in the quad, or excuse me, hamstrings a little bit more than if my foot was down. But really pushing into that heel, digging into those glutes and that hamstring. Switch over to your other legs.
Cycle four, complete.
So we have this, one more starfish, or one more set of one leg of bridges.
And
we'll bring it all the way down. So we're staying on the floor. Here. Breathe in and out for me. Final Tabata is right here. Breathe in and out. Alright, back to that starfish. Legs are wide, just a little bit wider than your shoulders. Arms are out wide. You look like a great big X. Opposite hand, opposite leg.
Prepare.
Here we go.
Work.
Boom. Breathe in and out for me. Try not to hold the breath. It's really easy to do on that one. Bring the feet in. Dig your heel into the ground. Opposite legs up. Press into that heel as you lift your butt up off the ground. Try not to hit your elbows. So we're going to drive our elbows in. Make that glute and hamstring do all the work. Just high enough to slide a towel underneath you. You don't have to go up super high. You're engaged. You just push that butt leave the mat. Or the floor.
Three, two, one.
Switch over to the other leg.
Seven, complete. Prepare.
There we go. Down and up. Down and up. Breathe in and out for me. Breathe in and out for me.
Three, two, one, rest.
All right,
and five.
Crisscross those and have that ankle for
1 minute.
I'm gonna get you over here. We're just gonna bring the heart rate down a little bit. Take your hands underneath your knees and just rock those legs side to side. Breathe it out for me.
A heart on the run, keeps a hand on.
Totally different genre here.
Angels.
Bring those knees into your chest for me.
So sure, but I need it.
Place your right foot on the floor. Place your left ankle on top of that knee. Gently press your left knee away from your body. While keeping your hand on that left knee, I want you to pick that right foot up off the floor. So pull in. As you press that knee, you should feel stretched to that depth. Just gentle, right here. Drop it down. Switch legs. Bring that right knee into the chest. Place that right ankle on top of the left knee and push that right knee away. Pick that left foot off the floor, pulling that left leg in gently, Press it away with that right hand. Place that left foot on the floor. Bring that right foot on the floor. Drop both knees to one side and roll over onto your knees. Extend that left leg all the way out. If you've got the flexibility, it's a great stretch. If you don't want to take this stretch, you can pick that left foot up. And the opposite arm. If you feel okay with this stretch, you're going to cross that right leg underneath the body. Slide back as deep as you can. Just hold this stretch. And the old lover say, I thought it'd be me who helped me home. You may find it's a little tighter on one side, that's normal. Home was a dream, one that I never seen. You came alone. Now that stretch slowly, go on to the other side. Extend the opposite leg. Cross that knee, cover leg underneath, and slide all the way back.